Thank you guys, and welcome to Fourni Learn. Please don't forget to subscribe, comment, share and give the video a thumbs up. Today, we will be learning how to record and perform live streams with Virtual DJ on Facebook and YouTube. This particular tutorial applies for those of us who are using version 8.0 and up. In previous versions, like the famous version 7 series, the settings are the same but the interface is slightly different. Please get the latest free version from virtualdj.com. So, on your Virtual DJ Pro layout, go to the top right corner and click on Configuration. On the left panel of items, navigate to Broadcast. Make sure that you have selected the video option. Down there, you are going to see the Stream to option. Change that to YouTube. The URL is set automatically, so skip that and go to Quality. The quality options are three. That is, high, medium and low. If you have a connection speed of above 10 megabits per second, you can use the high option. Any connection between 6 to 9 megabits per second can handle medium. Otherwise, select low. From there, click this link here. It will open the YouTube streaming on your default web browser. If you have never streamed before, you will be required to enable and verify your Google account. Follow the steps and verify your account. Make sure you select the correct country and enter your phone number. After verification, go back to Virtual DJ and click the link again. You will be taken to the YouTube streaming page again. You can also just visit youtube.com/stream to access the page. Alternatively, on the YouTube home page, on the top right corner, click on your account icon. On the list that appears, click on your channel. Go to Manage Videos, and that will launch the YouTube Studio. Choose the Dashboard tab on your left. On your channel dashboard, towards top right corner, you will see two buttons. One, for video upload, and another one for live stream. Click on Stream and that also takes you to the stream page. This panel here is for stream settings. Go to Edit. Enter your preferred title for your video stream and the description. Set your preferred privacy option. If you just want to test, you can start with the private option, and then after checking it out, switch to public. Select the appropriate category of your stream, and then check for any other settings you might want to change, if any. Check your live chat settings and make any changes if necessary. When done, click Save. Now YouTube is all set and ready to receive your stream. On the Stream Setting tab below, we need to get the stream key. To ensure safety, ensure that in every new stream, you reset your key. Now click on Copy to copy the stream key. Let's go back to Virtual DJ Broadcast settings. You need to paste your key, so use Ctrl plus V, or right-click then paste. And now we are all set to perform a live broadcast. Click on Start Broadcast. Close the settings window and go to the video tab on Virtual DJ Mixer section. The video source is set to shader by default. Go to Shader Settings and make sure to check Auto Change and Beat Move. Otherwise, Virtual DJ will only use one shader effect. Now, go back and load your tracks and start mixing. The stream will be happening live on YouTube's stream page, and that is what your viewers can actually see. The Analytics tab will show you stream information in real time. Once done streaming, go back to Virtual DJ and end your stream from this button, or proceed to Broadcast Configurations, and stop broadcast. Go back to YouTube and end your stream. You will have two options, to either dismiss or edit stream in studio. If you choose dismiss, that ends the stream and just saves the video the way it was streamed. If you choose to edit in studio, YouTube opens the video in their own video editor studio, where you can make changes to your streamed video. If you go back to channel content, and proceed to the manage video option, on the live tab, you can view and edit your streams. And now, let's stream on Facebook. To open the Facebook stream page, open your profile page. Go to live video. Facebook by default, is set to use your default camera. Now, change from the use camera option, to the use stream key option. Scroll down and as usual, reset the stream key and then copy. Go to Virtual DJ and open the configurations window. On broadcast video options, set the stream to option to Facebook. Ignore the URL, set your preferred stream quality, and paste your Facebook stream key. Now, click on Start Broadcast to broadcast your stream. Close the configuration window. Observe that it notifies you that your broadcast has already started, if you open the Master tab on Virtual DJ Mixer. Go back to the Video tab to make sure everything is okay. Load your tracks or songs and start mixing. Go back to Facebook and open the Dashboard tab, to monitor your stream. All the streaming information is provided in this section below. And this is the section where you can add the video stream title and all that. On the left pane, you can choose where to post the video stream. Down here, you can set the privacy to whatever option you prefer. Once you are satisfied that all your stream settings are okay, click on the Go Live option. Facebook will start broadcasting your content right away. When you are done streaming, you can end your stream here. Rate the quality of your broadcast, if you like, and the view, trim or create a clip from the stream. Let's view the post. From here, you can just delete if you don't want the video to be posted. Finally, let us record an audio or video file with Virtual DJ. On Virtual DJ Interface, go to Configurations. On the right side, select the Options tab. On the search bar, select All Settings. Now, search for Record. Check the record quality you want, and any other preferred options. Remember to select the video resolution you need, and then close the configuration window. From there, you can load your first track and get ready to record. To start recording, you can use this button here. Alternatively, you can open the configuration window, and down there, select Record. Change the video format to MP4 for video, or MP3 for audio. Remember, those are my settings, you can decide otherwise. Change the file name to the name you want to use. When done, click on Save. Now go back and press the Start Record button. Virtual DJ will be waiting for sound input to start recording. Make sure the video is okay before you start recording. Start playing your tracks and recording will start immediately. When you are done mixing, on the Master tab of Virtual DJ Mixer section, you can stop your recording with this button here. Otherwise, you can go back to Configurations, and on the Record tab, click on Stop Record. If you click on the Recorded File button, you can view the file in Explorer. You can also click on the Recorded File button and view it in Virtual DJ's browser. That's it for today, I hope you enjoyed, and don't forget to like and subscribe. See you around.